Hello, I'm Michael Pollitt, and I'm an assistant director at the Energy Policy Research Group at the University of Cambridge. And I'm going to be talking to you about business models for network companies. And let me start off by telling you a little bit about the experience of the UK with respect to electricity distribution regulation. The UK was one of the first countries in Europe to privatise and introduce incentive regulation for its electricity distribution companies in 1990. And at that time, it introduced a form of incentive regulation called RPI-X. And what that meant was that the maximum prices that the electricity distribution companies could charge for their services had to go up only at the rate of inflation less a productivity improvement factor, or X. And this was a very successful system of regulation until it was overhauled recently. Between 1990 and 2005, electricity distribution charges fell by 60% in real terms, and that was due to the successful system of regulation that was put in place. That system of regulation consisted of 5 yearly price control reviews. During those review periods, a central part of the review was the benchmarking of the individual distribution network companies against each other, and that led to comparison of their relative performance and the ability to set individual X factors according to how much scope there was for further cost reduction among the individual distribution companies. Two other important elements of the price control process which emerged over the period were the setting of incentives for the improvement of quality and the introduction of a scheme to incentivize innovation by distribution network companies. The quality incentive scheme consisted of incentivizing the firms to reduce customer minutes lost and customer interruptions, and that was also very significant in reducing the level of interruptions and the total length of interruptions over the 1992 period to today. And the recent incentives to innovate on the distribution system have provided distribution companies with the ability to raise extra revenue in order to pay for research, development and demonstration projects aimed at improving the potential for smart grid technologies to be introduced into the network and the efficient response to smart meter technology, among other things. So that's a bit of background on what's been happening in UK regulation over the recent period.